All right, guys, we're back again today with Lone Star Grills, and today we're going to do pork belly burn-ins. We're going to make a Dr. Pepper glaze to finish them at the end. We're going to do that on the Lone Star Grills pellet smoker today. Here we've got roughly a 6-pound slab of pork belly. If you don't know what pork belly is, basically this is just bacon before it's been cured and sliced, so you'll see that edge there. Skin has been removed. For this recipe, you do not want the skin on the pork belly. So most grocery stores carry this now. It's become very popular. And most of the time the skin won't be there, but just make sure the skin has been removed. So this is bacon. So this is gonna be that savory, that moist, tender, bits of fat in there that you know with bacon, but we're gonna make these into burn ends. So what we're gonna do, first before I get my hands all dirty, we're gonna get the glaze going. So the glaze is just gonna be Dr. Pepper, and we're gonna cook this down. So just two of these Dr. Peppers. Actually, I don't even know if two will fit in here. And we're gonna let this set on the stove on a decent simmer. Make sure you don't let it burn. We just wanna cook this down. We wanna get most of the water out and turn this into a glaze. So that'll go on the stove. That's super easy. We'll put that on in a second. Next, we're gonna cube this up into roughly 1-inch cubes. Now you can do this recipe whole and then cube it up at the end. You can do slices like this, like these big slices, and then cube it up at the end. The reason why I like to go and do cubes from the start is because cubes allow you to get that rub, that crust, that bark all the way around that piece of meat. It just develops a little bit better texture all the way around the meat instead of doing it at the very end. Now I'm not measuring this, but I'm just kind of eyeball it here to keep it nice and even. That way they all cook evenly. Up. Now, got two more ingredients here. So I've got a basic barbecue rub here that I whipped up real quick, mostly brown sugar, probably like 3 parts of brown sugar. I want more sugar than I wanted anything else, just to give it that sweet crust on the outside, to kind of caramelize on the outside. And then 1 part coarse kosher salt, 1 part coarse black pepper, some garlic powder, onion powder, paprika, and a little bit of celery seed. Then we're gonna use some yellow mustard here. We're just gonna use this as a binder. It's also gonna cut through. We're gonna have some of that vinegar tartness in the mustard here, which will help cut through all the sugar. Now we get a nice coating of the rub on the outside here. We'll toss this. And because these are small pieces of meat, we're gonna have rub on all the sides. That's one of the reasons why I wanted more sugar than I want salt and seasoning. We don't wanna over season this with too much salt for such a small piece of meat. Now this is really not necessarily something you'd have as a meal, although you could. This works better as an appetizer. We're still here in October. Still got baseball going on. We got football kicked off. So this makes a good appetizer for game day, birthday parties, whatever you got going on this fall or any time of the year. But this is definitely a good football appetizer, good fall appetizer. Get these coated. Toss this so we get coating on all sides here. All right. All right, now we got that nicely coated all the way around. We're gonna take this outside. We'll get it set up on the smoker outside. We'll show you what we got going on out there, how we're setting that up, and we'll get this going. All right, we're rolling some beautiful blue smoke here. Smoker set up at 250 for this cook. It's gonna go roughly 2.5 hours, plus or minus a little bit, at 250. That's when we'll come back. We'll pull it back, put it in a pan, and that's when we're gonna glaze it. Let's go ahead and get these on right now. For this part, we don't want it. We don't want it in the pan right now. We want to wrap that all the way around with the smoke. Get that bark to develop all the way around the outside. Then we'll come back in a minute. In a minute, 2.5 hours or so. And that's when we'll put it in the pan. That's when we're going to do our glaze. All right, last one. We got these on here. I've left plenty of room all the way around each one so that we can get smoke and form a bark on each one of these all the way around. That's the whole purpose of putting them on the rack and not leaving them in the pan for the first part of this cook. So we'll let this go, get it closed back up. We'll come back and check on this after about 2.5 hours when we're ready to glaze them. All right, guys, we're back. It's been about 2.5 hours. Burn-ins have been running at about 250 the whole time. We've got that Dr. Pepper glaze that I was telling you about earlier, showing you. That's reduced down almost into a Dr. Pepper syrup. I did add a tiny bit of cornstarch just to thicken it up a little bit, tighten it up some. Well, let's go ahead and take a look at these. Look at that. Starting to get a nice crust around the outside, nice bark on them, nice color to them. One thing I'll show you, I've seen a lot of videos and a lot of demonstrations before about burn ends. It's not literally burnt, so these are still nice, tender, and juicy. So we're going to go ahead, get these off, put them in the pan. We're going to cook these again. Once we get these in here, we're going to cook them about another 45 minutes or so and just let that glaze set. All right, got all those off. Again, not burnt. Burnt ends doesn't mean burnt. It's just a name that they've been given. Basically just cubed up, came from brisket burn ends, and then it's been adapted to the pork belly. So we're gonna drizzle this on, try and get it nice and even. Now, this is just something that I've done before. You can also do like a candied pepper jelly, raspberry chipotle, a peach glaze, bourbon, smoked bourbon glaze. There's all kinds of different glazes that you can put on there. So we're going to go ahead, throw that back on, just like that. We'll let that go for another 45 minutes, still at 250. We'll pull it off and check it when it's done. All right, guys, I've pulled the pork belly burn ends off the pit. They went that 45 minutes like we said they would. 250 for the entire cook. Sum total on this barbecue burn ends, or the pork belly burn ends, is somewhere around 3 hours 30 minutes. I did let them rest another 5 or 10 minutes just to, you know, redistribute those juices. You always got to let it rest when you're done. The bigger the item, the longer it needs to rest. So this doesn't need much. Just let it rest a few minutes. Take a look at the color that these have taken on, the glaze on the outside, that Dr. Pepper glaze that we put on there. Nice color all the way around. That's why we cubed it to begin with, so that it would have that bark, that color, that smoke would penetrate all the way around from all sides through the entire cook. It's not a long cook, so we cubed it up to begin with just so that it would take on a little bit more of that flavor profile from the smoke. But let's go ahead and try one of these, see how they turned out. Unbelievable flavor. We've got the rub coming through, the glaze on top. The meat is tender, juicy. The fat has rendered down, adds another depth of flavor. I mean, this is pork, this is bacon. I mean, what more could you ask for? This turned out absolutely perfect, and this recipe is ripe to be made your own. You don't have to follow this. The Dr. Pepper glaze is just an idea that you can use, run with it. If you don't like that, that's fine. Jellies, jams, brown sugar, a separate rub on top for a different profile. Add some heat, add the sweet, make it your own. For more information on the pit that we use to cook this and all of our other pits, check us out at LoneStarGrills.com. Don't forget to like and subscribe our channel. And if you want to give us a call, 936-494-3477.